Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum.
Greetings, ground crew team of our Galactic Alliance of the 144,000. Happy New Moon in Scorpio and All Saints Day on this powerful 111 portal. As we begin this new month of November, we begin with this triple one Trinity gate as we flow into the coming 1111 gateway. After yesterday's X-class solar flare, our local Solaris continues to inundate Gaia and all her children of the sun with cosmic rays of unity consciousness. Releasing another 5 C-class solar flares today and 4 more M-class flares, with the most powerful maxing at M2.06 at 1431 UTC. Nothing can stop what is coming or prevent all starseed Earth angelics of the 144 from fulfilling their divine birthrights of total freedom in the peace and prosperity of the new golden age of enlightenment for all our good people of the new Earth. In the awakened mind of Buddha, all things become possible as we tap into the genius within our DNA and our unlimited potential. As the electrical fire of ascension of the divine masculine of the Eagle Nation meets and unites with the magnetic waters of descension of the divine feminine of our sacred Condor Nation. All comes into perfect harmony with the music of the spheres and the balance of the five elements. Keep anchoring in the highest codes into the crystalline core of Mother Earth, as we make our quantum leap of consciousness into the new human species of Homo luminous, light bodies of Terra Nova Gaia, A'ho. Welcome, beloved beings of light. I am Paul White Gold Eagle, Keen 47, Blue Galactic Hand of our Universal Alliance of Light with PrimeDisclosure.com. We have many powerful transmissions again for you today from our sacred New Earth scribes, so be sure to listen to the very end where we release a very powerful New Moon in Scorpio prayer. And please do us a favor and share this video with your teams and tribes all over this realm. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below. And now we continue with Divine Sistar of the Light, Divine Feminine 7777. Scorpio New Moon Magic. Today's new moon in Scorpio is a powerful time for deep transformation and introspection. As the veil between worlds thins, we are invited to dive into the depths of our emotions and uncover hidden truths. Here's how this mystical lunar event is affecting us. Introspection and shadow work. Scorpio's energy encourages us to explore our inner shadows and embrace our vulnerabilities. It's a time to confront past traumas and heal old wounds, paving the way for profound personal growth. Emotional intensity. Expect heightened emotions and a strong urge to connect with your deepest desires. This new moon amplifies our passions and can bring buried feelings to the surface. Embrace this intensity as a catalyst for transformation. Spiritual awakening. With the acceleration portal happening right now, the cosmic energy is ripe for spiritual awakening and alignment. Use this time to set powerful intentions and manifest your dreams. The universe is listening. New beginnings. As we release what no longer serves us, we make space for new beginnings. Set your intentions clearly and watch as the universe conspires to bring your dreams to life. Embrace the magic of the Scorpio new moon and let its transformative energy guide you towards a brighter, more authentic self. From Divine Sistar of the Light Erini, Crystal and Indigo Guide to the Galaxy. Athena, the inner trinity, 144 flowing in. Happy new month. This is going to be the month in which the newly returned lost frequencies will begin flowing through all the spheres. We are deeply in the process of restoring the inner trinity in the physical body. The twin flame pendulum opened the path for the restoration of the health via the inner trinity. The new mother's vortex is here to support us in restoring our health. Message: the inner trinity has been under the state of misalignment and interference by what took place and the results of pain and trauma when the king of our hearts was killed. Unless the heart of the king is healed from this pain, this realm cannot return to balance. This is what is being revealed now, and all energies are working towards this healing, so that the king of our hearts will return in his glory and light. True history will be seen and understood. The next 4 days are bringing powerful creative and nuclear energies, but also shaking war and demonic energies and revelations that will take true inner focus in order to be balanced out. Many old situations are ending now, both within and without. Grieving is part of the process, but the acceleration is pushing for things to move forward in trust and faith. At the same time, divine gifts of love and abundance will be offered during the next days as hope and light are here for all. Many souls are leaving. The deepest of shadows, along with who is who, are being revealed more and more each day. Nothing was as it seemed, both within and without. We are very blessed to be here and experience these unique times of true physical awakening, and there is more, so much more to come. This is the great correction of time. Upon this correction, the ramification of time will be seen and understood. Everyone will gradually create a new understanding and interaction to time, as this is the biggest initiation so far, and one that is about true liberation from the fallen cycle and its mechanics. Blessings of inner correction, Erini, Amalthea Thor, Harzaronia, Hunama Anata Kumara, Yellow Galactic Warrior. And today from Divine Sistar of the Light, Shay from Numbers by Shay Numerology, 11-1-24, it's showtime. November is a circus, and you are the ringmaster. The lions and tigers are snarling. The clowns are clowning. Trapezes soar overhead. The fire eater is shooting flames in your direction. The elephants are dancing. The music is blaring, and you have to play to a crowd that's tough to please. But you've been practicing for this all year. You are the master of your energy, and you own your space. Today the spotlight bathes you in divine presence, and it believes in you. It is your right action to believe in yourself and shine your own light wherever you go. When all eyes are on you, and they will be, give them a show to remember. And today from Divine Brother of the Light, Diego E. Berman, Ph.D., from Shadow to Light, embracing November's transformative power, X2 Solar Flare Alert, November 1st, 2024. Dear friends, welcome to November, a month of transitions and renewal that invites us to embark on a profound journey of spiritual growth and transformation. And exactly as we are moving into this new month, our sun produced a strong X2 flare. Those of you who are energy sensitives may have felt this solar event during the past Halloween Eve, creating an even more special energetic experience. As we navigate this new energetic landscape, we are now being supported by the potent energies of the numbers 1 and 11, symbolizing unity, new beginnings, and spiritual awakening. The number 1, representing unity and oneness, connects us to the divine, embodying leadership, manifestation, and creation. This energy ignites our inner spark, inspiring innovation and fresh starts. As we step into November, we are encouraged to tap into this creative potential, birthing new possibilities and experiences. Meanwhile, the master number 11 amplifies our spiritual awakening, symbolizing enlightenment, higher consciousness, and the connection between the physical and spiritual realms. This powerful portal invites us to transcend limitations, embracing our true nature and soul's purpose. In the Kabbalistic teachings, number 1 represents the unity of the divine, while number 11 symbolizes the harmonious union between the physical and spiritual. Numerology associates number 1 with creativity, individuality, and leadership, whereas number 11 embodies spiritual mastery. In Christianity, November 1st marks All Saints' Day, honoring saints and spiritual leaders who embody the unity of God. The convergence of these energies create a sacred threshold for spiritual growth, renewal, and transformation. Astrologically, the Scorpio new moon on November 1st ignites a profound transformational journey, awakening the depths of our soul. The 1111 portal amplifies this energy, facilitating spiritual awakening, new beginnings, and higher consciousness. And most importantly, on November 19th, 1 plus 9 equals 10 equal 1, and after a year of going back and forth, Pluto will finally enter Aquarius for good, as it will stay in the water bearer sign for the next 2 decades. This is truly the dawning of a new age, as we get ready for fallen empires, rebellion, and a new vision for the world. As we embark on this transformative journey, we are invited to release old patterns, habits, and energies, making space for new beginnings. By resonating with the energies of November, number 1 and 11, we can tap into spiritual growth and transformation, releasing old patterns and habits, embody leadership and manifestation, connect with higher levels of consciousness and enlightenment, and cultivate deeper our sense of universal unity and oneness. May the transformative power of November awaken your inner strength, ignite your passions, and illuminate your path to a brighter, more radiant future. Happy New Moon, and stay tuned for more updates as we venture into this incredibly transformative new month. Have a great weekend. Much love. We are one. From DiegoBerman.com. And today from Divine Sistar of the Light, Lauren Carolyn Gorgo. Divine Justice. Return of Higher Law and Order. The Scorpio new moon marks our official exit from another deeply demanding yet transformational eclipse season in this supercharged year of the dragon, by which we have all been pushed to meet our divine potential as love. As a result of our accomplishments, the tide has fully shifted in our favor of the feminine, not just at the etheric level, but at the ground level, which means all that which is aligned with love will now hold sway over the land, heralding a cosmic reordering that will affect every layer and level of life on Earth. This shift will have far-reaching consequences, for the Cosmic Mother has returned to ensure that all life on this planet is honored and cared for on Earth as it is in heaven. Those who seek to destroy or derail this covenant with creation will no longer be permitted to do so, for the heavenly structures, original organic Stargate system, are now in place, returning the power to those who hold dear the well-being of all organic life forms. The Mother has spoken, and it is her will that nothing will deter, desecrate, or defile the sanctity of life on this planet any longer. Anything that hinders or forsakes the law of love will see its day of reckoning. With the reconstitution of the Mother Principle, Gaia herself is rising into her own power and authority, solar body, as the Christus frequency is returned to this planet to restore all life on Earth. This suggests that our beloved Mother, the sacred container that supports the higher frequency beings for the new human, new Earth experience, now has a say over what she will and will not accept as the law of the land returns to her jurisdiction. More than anything, this means that the new Earth trajectory is not only set in motion, but is becoming realized. As such, for those prepare to ride this wave of cosmic love to the shore, you will find that what greets you there is more welcoming than what you may have initially imagined, for the people of Earth are far more ready to receive you than it may seem on the surface. For that reason, light and love workers are being called to rise, to stand in solidarity with Gaia by stepping into our own divine authority as love to propagate this power worldwide. This is a coming of age for the planet, and so all who join her in the return to spiritual adulthood will be unconditionally upheld as the legions of heaven have mandated long ago. For those who do, those who make the leap into the cosmic state, this month offers the entrance, gateways into the heaven on earth experience at the mundane level of life, with the full support of the universe to guide and provide for you. This promises that those with purity of heart who care about what truly matters will no longer be put last. That is this new heavenly hologram. Those who respect and honor the sacredness of life above all else will take the lead as inheritors of the kingdom. Know, too, that the rise of the Christess via the transfer of power to the goddess energy on earth is fully commensurate with the law of one, and that the interconnectivity of all things is coming into plain view to be seen and acknowledged by all those who fail to abide by the basic tenets of the universe. Soon enough, what goes around will come around at record speed to ensure that the mother's message is widely and swiftly received, indicating a time of retribution, of justice, of comeuppance, not in the biblical sense, but in the cosmic sense, where love is law. From New Earth Institute. Love. 144, continuing to quantum flash in. From Divine Sis Star of the Light, Natalia Alba. Beloved ones, the process of density emancipation has already begun for many of you stepping into this path and those choosing to consciously shift their bodies. We are now immersed in a potent soul transmission, together with the Scorpion Lunation, whose energies will too facilitate the process of emotional healing that many of you are undergoing. This is a time of profound liberation at all levels, for only when we govern our bodies, mind, and consciousness is that we are free. It is a time when many of you may feel emotionally challenged, as these waves bring to the surface all we hide within that needs to be released. Embrace it. Love all of who you are and have ever experienced, as the only way to neutralize your past and parallel selves' influences. Emotional healing occurs at many levels, psychological, soul, mental, and spiritual, and we shall treat all aspects of who we are equally. There are somatic techniques and EFT techniques to help you release physical blockages as a result of emotional damage, and many others that can help you let go of what has become stagnant in your emotional body. These 2 months are crucial in our crossing to our new destination, for next year will be a year of termination at all levels and physical initiation for many, which will involve the liberation of physical blockages and density to continue our crystalline process. We also have the healing influence of Jupiter sextile Chiron tomorrow to help us increase the healing transmissions received at this time. For when we ask, it is law to receive, and every time we ask for assistance, whether we are prepared to feel it or not, it is always sent. We just need to surrender and embrace it in the way it comes. With the current energies, my guides invite us to work on the following as the most important for those who wish to start the process of physical emancipation. DNA clearing of all artificial influences, programs, and inserts that cause unconscious repetitions of non-beneficial habits and patterns, and all self-sacrifice beliefs we carry within our DNA, inherited epigenetically or self-created. All of us have slavery records in our DNA, whether through past life experiences or galactic ones. And it is pivotal when working on freeing our consciousness to start by clearing all of our DNA records of all that still creates these false patterns. Our bone structure system is being tremendously impacted by the loss of density, as many of you are already feeling, for those who have inflammation diseases and or arthritis, arthrosis, or other similar ones. This may be even more challenging, and you may need to do other therapies to help you remain balanced and, above all, with the least possible pain. The nervous system is one of the most affected parts of our anatomy in ascension, for it is responsible for transmitting all the light we descend through the spine and the rest of the organs, and it is commonly the most imbalanced due to emotional triggers and many other anomalies. Brain-heart complex, and especially the importance now of our sphenoid bone, as I recently shared, and all of our brain and heart complex to receive the divine transmissions that keep us connected to authentic sources, to our unified self and our personal guides team, which are often future parallel aspects of us. This is what brings balance into our being, so our mind does not govern our being or our emotions, but both functioning as one. Polarity integration, releasing duality inserts, geometry, and starting to embrace Trinity through Hara line reconnection, removal of dual geometries within our brain structure, and all we need to release that creates fragmentation. This work also involves the unification of our shoulder blade portals and all 6th and 7th dimensional body channels that are linked to them. There are many other important parts of our bodies we may need to work with and that will be revealed to us, for we are all unique and the process of density emancipation, as my guides named it, will impact us all differently. During our ascension journey, especially during these times of integration, remembering the importance of conscious nutrition is essential not to exhaust our bodies. Detox is fine as long as we do not take it too far to cause more misalignments in our bodies. As always, the quality of water is vital to allow the free flow of the light transmissions we are receiving, as well as to properly release what we are letting go. Disengaging or unplugging from the 3D manipulative traps is what will allow us to be still, listen to our soul, reconnect with it, and above all, detect our consciousness controlling mechanisms, liberating ourselves from them. Guides also invite us to work on practicing love and kindness in our meditation toward our bodies, talking to our DNA to help in its reconnection and healing, and balancing the ego as we navigate these new energies. Being kind to yourselves is one of the most important things to your well-being. This is a very long process in which many times we will feel confused, alone, or depressed due to the many life changes it involves. Other times there will be joy, creativity, and instant manifestation, for this path is full of wonders as well. It all depends on how we look at what happens to us and how we choose to deal with what happens to us. Witnessing everything from an outside perspective helps us in knowing what is truly taking place, what we need, and how we can best solve the situation. When we understand that we can be the love we search outside and start practicing it for ourselves, as we too want to send it to others, all starts shifting, for we start allowing healing to occur in our bodies. We are heading into the soul dimensions, where we cannot lie to ourselves or others, for there is nothing we can ever hide in these soul planes. When there is no love for the self or self-care, there cannot be integration and assistance to others. This is why recognizing ourselves as divine beings and treating ourselves and our bodies as such is so important to achieve physical ascension. This path is not about us, but about all together as one. However, as individualized aspects of the divine, it is our personal mission to honor our divinity and how she or he chooses to express herself or himself through us. I wish you a loving, healing, and revealing passage, beloveds. May you love and honor yourselves and your bodies completely and perpetually. Within infinite love, from NataliaAlba.com. And today, from Ascension Lightworkers to the Ascension Lightworker Collective. The new moon on November 1st, 2024 in Scorpio activates transformational energies, encouraging deep self-reflection, renewal, and embracing changes. It provides opportunities to delve deeper into the subconscious, letting go of what no longer serves the ascending self. Scorpio season is the embodiment of introspection, transformation, and the need for inner change. Scorpio is the representation of the dark night of the soul. It is a time of death and rebirth. The next new moon in November, on the 1st, is activating a significant energetic reset for ascending individuals and the collective consciousness, leading to the crumbling of 2 to 3D outdated structures as mass exposure is highlighted and well underway. The duality and current state of the world on this planet is a clear depiction of the battle between forces of darkness and light. This battle energy is infused in fear, control, manipulation, and is a direct reflection of the ongoing 2 to 3D collective consciousness experiencing itself here on Earth. As higher frequencies of light enters our planet, the hidden depth of the present darkness is now coming to the surface, becoming more evident, visible, and apparent. The increased influx of light is illuminating all that has been previously hidden. The darker internal aspects will reveal the true nature of individuals, government systems, and global leadership structures. The exposure of darkness is a big and very necessary step in the process of collective ascension, awakening, and transformation. It is a golden opportunity for awakening individuals and society as a whole to recognize and confront the shadow aspects on this planet that has been inappropriately influencing human behavior and the overall collective dynamics. The conflict between dark and light is a representation of the struggle between divided and opposing energies. The goal, always in ascension, is to move towards higher alignment with vibrational frequency of God's light, love, compassion, and higher consciousness. This planetary shift is an essential part of the evolution of humanity and the unfolding of a more enlightened and harmonious world. These planetary alignments are promoting and catalyzing profound shifts in consciousness. This current ascension Earth energy represents a significant turning point and a complete reset. The energies of this new moon are creating a merging bridge with the Halloween energy portal frequencies. These particular energies are intensifying as the veils between the physical realm and higher dimensions are now becoming much thinner, possibly resulting in the energies around self coming into the physical manifestation form. These energies play a role not only in the ascension of our crystalline light bodies and the anchoring of a new earth template of divine love, but also in illuminating our shadow aspects as we navigate through the planetary energies, participating in the cycles of death and rebirth during these Scorpio energies. The incoming planetary plasma light particles embody high frequency energy as well as upgraded ascension codes, activate the divine union template in self, the divine purpose, and the sacred kundalini merging of the divine feminine and divine masculine counterparts, both internally and externally. All of this is preparing for the 111 energy portal, with the energies reaching their peak on the 1111 Master Gateway Portal, reminding us that the most important thing in ascension that you can ever truly control and manage is your own energy. The current solar flare activity is emitting intense energy onto our planet. This is having an impact on individual ascension experiences. These profound internal shifts and increased awakenings are accelerating ascension levels. The internal changes the self is consciously making here on ascending new earth are sending high vibrational ripple effects of frequencies throughout the cosmos. Everything is energy, and in New Earth energy, the emphasis is on matching the frequency of the reality desired. You cannot help but get that reality. It can be no other way. This is not philosophy, this is physics. Physical reality is a reflection of what's going on in our belief systems and in our own energy. Manifestations will continuously attract further opportunities for creating more manifestations. These opportunities will reflect self's vibration, allowing the self to act upon them effortlessly, without struggle or difficulty. Each opportunity presented in New Earth reality will align with expressing the self effortlessly, as the true essence of who the self is. When we allow this, the universe operates in this harmonious manner. The ascending are trusting the timing and natural order in all things, no longer allowing the lack of immediate results to derail, understanding that numerous unseen factors are in motion, influencing the timing of events. Having faith that any perceived delays have a higher purpose. Change may appear suddenly and unexpectedly after a long period of stagnation. The ascending collective are maintaining their center, grounding themselves in meaningful stillness and inner peace. Ascending souls together are navigating through these fluctuating times on Earth with collective clarity, purpose, determination, and resiliency. In loving and devoted ascension service from Ascension Lightworkers. And today from Divine Sis Star of the Light Judith Kusel, we are entering a quantum leap in consciousness as the old falls away, yet it is not comfortable to leave the old. The familiar duality, separation, the judgments of self and others, which caused even more separation, the mudslinging, pain and suffering, and so much more. All of this will be in our faces, fighting desperately to stay alive and not to disintegrate completely. Deep down, your soul knows the true way. It recognizes the point of no return. It has no wish to play out the old roles, the old games of divide and conquer, the old bullying tactics any longer. It knows that in truth there is no competition. There is no need to divide. There is no need to convince others that you are better, smarter, or whoever else. Your soul remembers unity, oneness, harmony, and peace. Your soul remembers transcendental love, deep caring, communities working together as one. It knows there is no need for boundaries, nor fighting, nor lying. When you are seeing through and live life with integrity and love, you have no need to hide anything, nor hide yourself. Enter the new human race, where every soul shines in its own uniqueness and lovingly contributes to the whole. Where there is no need for politicians, religions, institutions, and all which loves playing games of divide and conquer, judgments, outsmarting each other and all that entails. The new humanity values honesty, love, and integrity, and unity and oneness. It seeks wholeness. It seeks the universality. It honors all life and all life forms and cherishes the earth, and all within and around and above her. It honors her soul. Yet that new human, that new earth, is first found within you before you can live it without. This is why this time is so important. What do you choose? 333 coming in. To continue the old earth's woes, or finally heal and grow into the magnificence of the new creation. The choice is yours. From JudithKusel.com. And today from Divine Sis Star of the Light Carolyn 144 God Code. Your journey of blessed change is near. This weekend invites you to rest and get balanced before starting on this new adventure. A weekend gateway is beneficial if guided. Connect with Mother Earth, crystals, and nature for extra support and healing. They will help open the mind to the love, healing, and abundance that you are moving into. Focus on peace to align with the flow of the changes. God bless you, love Carolyn, from 144godcode.com. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Ra James. Happy Scorpio New Moon. This new moon energy is very strong. It is the first day of a new month. We have also entered into the last 8 weeks of 2024. It's a great time to declutter energetically. This new moon is bringing major cleansing vibes and letting go of the energies of the past year. This new moon is bringing major get organized vibes. New moons bring new beginnings. This new moon falls into the threshold sign of death during the time of year when the veil between worlds is thinnest. This makes us very open to the spiritual. New moons are potent times for manifesting. It's all about making your wishes a reality. This new moon is great for getting more clear on what you want and where you are headed. This new moon brings an intense opposition between Mars and Pluto. This may be bringing up any fears or insecurities you need to heal still. Scorpio is all about the deeper shadows and shadow work. We also have Juno forming a T-square with them. Juno is all about relationships and commitment. She is also in Libra at this time. That means this new moon will be triggering any unresolved relationship dynamics. Expect major relationship shifts with this one. The energy of this T-square will bring a huge release and recalibration. It helps you to move forward into a new chapter. This alignment is all about releasing old relationship dynamics that no longer serve you, so you can shift into a deeper alignment. Many may cross paths with a new romance or a new chapter will occur in your existing relationship. From SparksOfDivineLightHealing.com. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Tanaz, the Scorpio New Moon arrives on the auspicious 11-1. The first day of the 11th month, 111, has long been considered a high vibrational angel number that helps us to manifest and bring balance to our mind, body, and soul. If you could use some reassurance, if you could use some hope that angels are on your side, allow this new moon to be your reminder. You are being looked after. There is a plan. There is a path. All you have to do is trust and keep the faith. From ForeverConscious.com. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Kirsty Elizabeth. 1st of November, New Moon in Scorpio, All Saints Day, 11-1 Portal. Sparks are likely to fly for those who can feel the burst of activity alighted by this day. The focus of the new moon is on renewal, and the space in which to work to bring in the new is now spick and span, following the hard work of the elemental realms across our natural space across recent weeks. If you are looking for a phoenix moment, here it is, as rebirth is at the heart of the agenda. Here is another magical day for energetic workers to shift and transform and to manifest new blessings for themselves and others. With all the saints behind us, our good intentions, prayers, and affirmations can come to life to create a new frequency connected to the highest of highs. The 111 portal is the first day of an 11-day angelic portal, which speaks to us on multiple levels and can be a time of slowing down to feel more. Angelic guidance is often invisible due to its high resonance. Often the effects of it are at first felt as the accumulation of that which is being cleared, becoming felt within our atmosphere. It can have a strong emotional focus, which sometimes agitates toxins and residual energy to show up for clearance, but ultimately has a positive and loving intention to support you and your emotional journey. 111 is a portal in its own right and is a powerful time of angelic and spirit world connection with our guardian angels at the forefront of our invisible support network. This then is all about soul contracting and delivering us new codes to feel the frequency of where we might be going. This is the energetic nature of angelic guidance and is how we feel its resonation deep within us. The elemental angels offer support to this via nature portals, which bring frequency through to our environment. The connection that sensitives feel from this is that which has been labeled as supernatural and has been much feared by those who cannot physically sense these invisible realities. This is why the 11-1 to 11-11 11-day portal has a joint focus of supporting mission and clearing karmic debt of that which has been persecuted or suppressed during our human life experiences. As is usual, angelic work flows to us on a divinely feminine frequency, which often puts the physical focus on feminine issues or gender-related aspects of the self-awareness journey. This may show up as masculine and feminine issues of balance, both of the physical and spiritual realms. If you have felt oppressed or vulnerable by the patriarchal systems, then perhaps it might be prudent to expect a time of reviewing these issues and experiences with the support of your angel and spirit guides. Also, too, we might expect a little rawness to reemerge around our perceptions of masculine and feminine behaviors and the effects held within our conscious and unconscious actions. This is all part of the shadow working focus, which often presents itself to us through the Scorpio season. Here, the intuitive wisdom of spiritual awareness and sixth sense abilities helps to elide us what has been hidden, be it by elusive or deceptive creation. The talents of Scorpio are all about unearthing secrets to seek truth, and this can be an important theme for collective learning at this time. And today, from Divine Sistar of the Light, Ruby Falconer, November 1st, 2024, New Moon at Scorpio, 9 degrees, 35 minutes, 8:47 a.m. EDT. This new moon is dominated by three powerful oppositions: Mercury in Scorpio, opposite Uranus in Taurus; Mars in Cancer, opposite Pluto in Capricorn; Venus in Sagittarius, opposite Jupiter in Gemini. The first two hook up with one another to form a pattern called a mystic rectangle, which is just what it sounds like. A synthesis of energies creating a magical relationship that makes a profound impact on our collective realities. The planets involved in the mystic rectangle are Mercury, communication and thought processes; Mars, creative action and anger; Uranus, the great awakener; Pluto, the transformer. In Egyptian myth, these are Thoth, Set, Wajet, and Osiris, all powerful agents of change. At this Scorpio new moon, our consciousness and actions are deeply aligned, motivated by intense forces of change. The third opposition, Venus opposite Jupiter, Isis, and her son Horus, brings to focus the prevailing conflict of values which dominates our culture. This new moon comes on Samhain, All Saints' Day, the day after Halloween, part of the festival of the Day of the Dead. The energies are deep, dark, and mystical, very Plutonian, and very Scorpio. During this moon cycle, Saturn will station in dreamy Pisces and turn direct. Pluto will enter Aquarius, a major shift that will last for 20 years, and Mercury will turn retrograde in Sagittarius. And we here in the United States will have our presidential election, a monumental event for us and indirectly for the entire world. Tensions are high and the outcome is murky. Welcome to the deep waters of Scorpio. Breathe deep and dive in. This moon cycle will last from November 1st to November 30th and December 1st. From ShamanicStarology.com. And from Divine Sistar of the Light, Colleen Lema, on Friday, November 1st, we have a new moon at 9 degrees Scorpio, sign of the Scorpion, Eagle, and Phoenix. The Scorpion asks that we purge and transmute what we no longer need to carry in our subconscious and our energy field. The Eagle asks that we see things from a higher perspective and fly to greater heights with our vision and dreams. The Phoenix asks that you rise from the ashes of your past, move through the process of transformation, spread your sacred wings, and rebirth yourself into a new way, a new life, and a new way of being. This new moon in Scorpio is connecting with Saturn, the great teacher of karmic lessons, in spiritual Pisces. This is assisting us in letting go of the past and aiding us to manifest the future that we desire to live in. Blessings of love and light to all from sacredsoulempowerment.com. 111 coming in. And today from Divine Sistar of the Light, Leah Whitehorse. New Moon in Scorpio. Mercury in Scorpio. Try Neptune retrograde in Pisces. Here is the skeleton key. The bare bones you asked for. The dream answer. The whisper in a quiet room. Here is the jiggling of chains and the moans of the past. That old soul not quite put to rest who taps at the window within. With Halloween and Samhain still fresh in the air, we are uniquely attuned to the dark and to the light, for here it all comes together into dazzling reality. How glorious it is to live and love and laugh whilst we can for tomorrow. We know not what may come. Tomorrow is hopefully far away, but still, Spirit tells me that the line must stand, for we are all on a limit of breaths and heartbeats. But this is the beauty I am told, and I know. One life in this incarnation, in this timeline, in this now. And here you are, with this offer of a brand new start, a clean slate, a debt repaid, such richness, such power, as Mary Oliver said. Tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? From LeahWhitehorse.com. And today from the Dzogchen Times, Keen 117, Red Cosmic Earth. Cosmic is the name for the number 13, and its keywords are transcend, endure, and presence. This is the final day of the Red Serpent Wave Spell, and as always, the last day sums up the journey that began on day one. We have arrived at our destination. Contemplate the lessons learnt this last 13 days. We must endure to transcend, meaning we must strive for what is important. It doesn't just land in your lap. Today is Red Earth, which represents evolution, synchronicity, and navigation. So what are we striving for? Evolution. The point of the Red Serpent Wave Spell is to shed our old skins and emerge renewed. That was the agenda all along. A perfect ending to a 13-day journey, which really tested our patience and strength. If you wish to evolve, you must put in the hard work, is the message here. Today is not easy, but potentially very progressive. And today from Divine Sistar of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio, Red Cosmic Earth, 13 Kaban, Keen 117, 1st of November, 2024. Birthing the new evolutionary cycle. Happy All Saints Day. Keen 117 equal 9, destiny, service, compassion, humanity, grace. Welcome to November. November is the 11th Gregorian month, which is a portal month. 11 symbolizes a doorway or gate to a new dimension and reality. And by gaining a new perspective, we become illuminated. Therefore, November promises to transport us to a whole new level of growth and awareness. November is Scorpio month and opens on the Halloween portal, which flows into All Saints Day and All Souls Day on November 1st and 2nd. Big energies initiating this huge transformational month. Today is All Saints Day, which is a day to honor the great ascended masters who came before us to light the way. 11 reduces to 2, which brings the spotlight on pairings and coupling. Romance is in the air. The 2 also highlights duality issues and possible polarity conflicts needed to be resolved in order to reach unity. The 2 added to 2024 equal 8 adds up to 10 equal 1. Thus, November 2024 is a 10-1 universal month. This denotes manifestation and perfection, with the ability to bring our dreams into fruition. The one starts a new cycle where we can initiate something unique and individual, drawing on our gifts. Big themes and issues as we return from the underworld and soar in the upper world. Lots of golden phoenix opportunities this month. Portals, doorways, illumination, and new beginnings on Keen 117, marking a giant step in our evolution through synchronicity and earth magic. Aho, much magic awaits through these intense journeys, beloveds. Day 13 in the Red Serpent Wave Spell of Survival, Instinct, Kundalini Rising, Life Force, Passion, and Rapid Transformation through Shedding Our Old Skin. Today we complete our baptism of fire with Cheek Chan and shed our old skins. We are transcending our survival and scarcity wounding, ready to rebirth ourselves through this evolutionary passage. Renewal and regeneration is the order of the day. Expanding our kundalini through our crown and our soul star chakras, bursting out to become one with the cosmos, our crowning glory. Tone of creation, cosmic is the last and final tone of creation, the highest octave. Tone 13 operates in the spiritual realm. 13 is the mystical number of the cosmic order, the goddess, and synchronic natural time. Cosmic action transcends, power endures, essence presence. Today you have incredible spiritual power at your disposal to transcend all those old patterns and transform them by your pure presence, through your kundalini rising, attaining cosmic consciousness. Our DNA has been upgraded and our light quotient increased as our cells are rejuvenated and our light body is glowing. We have arrived. Add some. I am here. This is the stage of having transcended the physical, emotional, and mental realms and arriving at cosmic consciousness. Today's question is, am I ready to transcend the old earth paradigm and birth a new higher consciousness in this new evolutionary cycle? We bid adieu to Red Serpent, who challenged us to evolve through raising our kundalini, clearing our channel, and aligning with the cosmos. Cheek Chan uncovered our deepest, darkest survival fears, stirred up our passion, our life force, and gave us much-needed wisdom and vitality. We have transcended our old 3D bodies, having energetically shed our old selves. We have activated and encoded our DNA and upgraded our cellular gold print. We are now ready to set forth on the next exciting chapter of our journey. Tomorrow we commence a brand new revealing wave spell with Eight's Knob, taking us into the Hall of Mirrors, where we journey into uncovering our true, authentic, new and upgraded selves in the magical dream spell. Divine blessings for the transcendence of the old, outdated, and outmoded you, birthing the new, shiny, cosmic you. In la ketch a la keen, Christina White Magnetic World Bridger, Keen 66. Keen 117, Red Cosmic Earth. The mantra, the code for today is, I endure in order to evolve, transcending synchronicity. I seal the matrix of navigation. With the cosmic tone of presence, I am guided by the power of birth. And on this powerful day of activations, transformations, and manifestations, let us know, beloved beings of light, in the comments below, what you're feeling, what you're seeing, your dreams, your visions, and your synchronicities. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below and the little bell to get notifications on future updates. And as always, we have a link in the description below to the transcriptions of today's transmissions, and we archive these on our website, primedisclosure.com. Now I'd like to take the time to thank everyone supporting us in our work and mission. It's because of your monthly pledges and donations we're able to continue our work. So if you'd like to help support our work, our mission, and help us continue bringing these free daily transmissions to the world, you can make a monthly pledge to our Patreon page at whitegoldeagle.com. Now I'd like to thank Divine Sister of the Light, DeAnna Fraley, for another donation. Thank you very much, Divine Sister. We appreciate you and your continued support, and we appreciate all of you that continue to support us in our work and mission. We couldn't be doing this work without you, so we're very grateful for each and every one of you. If you'd like to support our work and mission with a one-time donation, you could do so to our PayPal or Stripe accounts. Both links are at egolovecondor.com. Now we're going to complete today's transmissions with a powerful new moon and Scorpio prayer. Divine Spirit, as the new moon rises in Scorpio, I open my heart to transformation and healing. Under Scorpio's potent energy, I ask for the courage to dive deep within, embracing my shadows and releasing what no longer serves my highest good. May this night of new beginnings guide me to explore my inner depths, to heal wounds that weigh heavy on my soul, and to emerge renewed and empowered. Help me find strength in my vulnerability and clarity in the mysteries of life that are ready to unfold. Grant me the wisdom of Scorpio's insight, allowing me to release fears, to step into my authentic power, and to trust in my own rebirth. As I set my intentions, may they be infused with resilience, passion, and purpose. With gratitude, I welcome this new moon's gifts of transformation, depth, and clarity. So it is. Thank you for joining us today, beloved beings of light. Have a most beautiful, blessed, and restful weekend ahead as we continue our journey through the ascension portal and into our new heaven upon the new earth. Keep walking gently your sacred path with heart, with peace and love in every step. And keep shining your light brightly into the night. Be sure to make this day and every day the best day ever. The eagle and the condor love you all. Namaste.